So what is this test? All of us know that this test is your Medox. Medox rot test. Yes. And what will be the result of a patient who has exophoria? Now, we already know that in exophoria, we will have crossed diplopia. And in cases of the eso, we will have uncrossed. Right? So, we will have to tell the interpretation. Yes, it is a Medox-Rot test. Medox-Rot test. Eh? Now, first of all, try to understand why we get crossed and uncrossed diplopia. Yes. Suppose we are having a patient here who is having the eso. Eso ho gaya. Theek hai? The eyes are deviated inwards. And this is the back side of the eyeball here. We have divided here. So, this is the nasal retina, temporal retina. Okay? Now, because eyes are deviated medially, so now the rays are also entering on the medial side and they are striking the nasal retina. So, they are here the rays are going on the nasal retina, here also they are going on the nasal retina. Now, when the rays are striking the nasal retina, the field will be in the opposite one. So, now this is going to form the image in the image where in the temporal visual field. Temporal visual field here. And here also it's going to form in the temporal visual field. So, that means right eye image is formed on the right side and the left eye image is formed on the left side. So, there is no crossing over. Agar hum aise bhi dekhenge, so eyes are deviated nasally here. So, this image is formed here and this image is formed here. So, there is no crossing here. Okay? So, this is your eso which is leading to the uncrossed diplopia. On the other hand, if I have the exo. So, exo mein, we have something like this and we have something like this. So, here the eyes are deviated outer side like this. So, what will happen if you look at the retinas here like this. So, now they are striking which retina? Temporal retina. Here also they are striking the temporal retina. Okay? Now, from this temporal retina, the image is formed in the nasal visual field. Here also, the image is formed in the nasal visual field. Can you see this crossing here? The eyes are deviated outward. So, this will form the image on the nasal visual field. This will form the image on the nasal visual field. Can you see this cross? So, this is your exo. Exo leading to the crossed diplopia. This is exo which is leading to cross diplopia. So, that means now we are sure that if they are asking you exo, it should be crossed. Okay? Now, this is the right eye and this is the left eye. So, right eye will start showing a line because a Medox rod will convert it into a line. So, this will show a line while this eye will see a dot reflex only. This will see a dot. Now, if I am saying that it is crossed, then it should come to this side. But what is happening? Now, this is a common confusion. The answer is not this. The answer is this only. While it is on the same side. Ye right mein hai and this is left. But the answer is this. Because this is the difference between the patient's view and your view. So, they are showing it on the right side. So patient will see on the opposite side. So patient, this is the right side of the patient, this is the left side of the patient. So patient should see this line on the left side and you will see on the opposite side. So this is your view. So if we are seeing it on the right side, patient will see on the other side, left side. So it is something like this. Whenever they are giving you like this, so if you are having the simultaneous perception, this is the nose squint. You are having the simultaneous perception where you are having the overlapping. So if overlapping is there, that means there is no fovea. Okay, na? When it is lying on the same side, see this, I have put the Medox rod here and you are getting it on the same side. That means it is exo because you have to turn it other way around according to the patient's view and your view. So when you are interpreting this kind of a question, you have to consider them the opposite. If you are seeing it at the same side, then it is exo. And when you are looking at the opposite side, then it is eso. So I hope it's clear and now you do not have the confusion because many of you were asking about this thing in your app also. So I think now it's clear. So if you are getting it on the same side, that means patient is looking at it on the opposite side. And that is why the answer to this question is B. All right. Then coming to the next one. Now, can you tell me what is the refractive error? This is again very interesting. What simples are you are looking like this and we have done this retinoscopy. It is one of the interpretations of the retinoscopy and they are just asking you whether it is a plus one, means is it a hypermetropia, or minus one, matlab myopia equal to one diopter ho gaya, theek hai, plus 0.5. So it is what? It is again hypermetropia and minus 0.5. So it is myopia less than one diopter. So can you tell me, let me see how many of you can answer this. Bahut simple hai. If you remember the interpretations, one was your no movement. If you are not able to see any movement, that means myopia is exactly equal to one diopter. Number two, if you are having a long movement, along ka matlab kya hota hai, either it is myopia which is less than one diopter, or it could be emetropia, or it could be even the hypermetropia. And if you are getting the against movement, against, that means myopia more than one diopter. So the thing is that you should know what kind of movement is this. If you know what kind of movement is this, the answer will be very clear to you. So tell me, anybody who can tell, what kind of movement is this? Is it a no movement, a long movement, or is it a against movement? I will also show you this, what kind of movements we have. So you are dilating the pupil and then we are doing the retinoscopy. We are looking at the patient's fundus through this retinoscope. So what is your with movement? Now see, this is the reflex that you are seeing inside and this is your movement, right? This is your movement. So your movement is in this direction and you are looking at the reflex that is also going in this direction. So obviously this will be with movement or the long movement. Now this is here, you are going again this way, but the reflex inside is going this way. So you can see this is your against. So this is your against movement. And in the third one, you'll see this is your reflex here. Now this is also going here and reflex is also going. So this is again with movement. But sometimes you do not get any movement and it is just filling inside. It is just filling inside. So can you see there is no movement? It has just filled whole totally. So this is your no movement. This is no movement. And no movement means what? Myopia equal to one diopter. So answer will be this. Is it plus 1 or minus 1? It should be minus 1 because myopia equal to 1 diopter will give me no movement. So it will not be plus 1, it will be minus 1. Plus 1 to ho jayega hypermetropia, and hypermetropia will give me the along movement. This is also hypermetropia, this will also give me a long movement. And myopia less than 1 diopter will also give me a long movement, while this will give me no movement. So answer will be B. This will give me no movement. Theek hai? Is it clear, everybody? Now coming to the next one. What is this? Again, a very interesting question, and many times it has been asked in your AIIMS examination. Can you see? In the first picture, you are having just the baseline. So, baseline mein kya hai? There is no movement. Theek hai? So, patient is just seeing straight ahead. There is no movement. And they have written it this right. So, this is your right eye. This is your left eye. So, when the patient is looking in the right gaze, this is within the normal limits. Right gaze is within the normal limits because this eye should be abducting, it is abducting, and this eye is also showing the adduction. Theek hai na? This is showing abduction, this is showing adduction. So we have normal abduction, normal adduction. But when the person is looking in the left gaze, theek hai na? Left gaze mein, this eye should have abduction, which is there, but there is no adduction here. So that means right eye mein, I have adduction deficit. Deficit along with contralateral abduction, because abduction is there, but they have said that also we have nystagmus. So we have abduction nystagmus. So we have right eye adduction deficit with contralateral abduction nystagmus. So what is this? So that means it is a case of right eye internuclear ophthalmoplegia, or I can also say right eye ka MLF lesion, or I can say it's a left gaze palsy. Any of the three methods I can have: right INO, right MLF, or the left gaze palsy. So answer will be medial longitudinal fasciculus. See if it's clear, because again this is a hiding concept and a very important for this examination. Yes. I do not know which question you are answering, this B and C. Zehra, it's not B. B will be your fourth nerve palsy, and fourth nerve palsy will give you the vertical diplopia. And here you are having a problem in the horizontal gazes, not the vertical gazes. So this is not a fourth nerve palsy. It could be a third nerve palsy because medial rectus is supplied by this, but then that will not cause this abduction nystagmus. So it is typically a case of internuclear ophthalmoplegia. Theek hai? Then another AIIMS question, which is important because they are asking you the questions on the abnormal pupillary reactions. Now, if you look at this image, in the first image, there is no light. So, this is your normal size of the pupils. There is no light. So, this is your normal size of the pupils, you can see. Now, this they have themselves also told that this is right eye. So this is the right eye here and this is the left eye here. So when I'm showing the light in this left eye, can you see constriction? So this is direct light reflex which is present, and in the right eye also we have, so indirect light reflex is also present. So that means left eye ki optic nerve intact hai. Optic nerve is intact. Left eye optic nerve is intact because we have direct also and we have got indirect also. But when I am swinging my hand to the left eye, this is called as a swinging flashlight test. So when I am swinging my hand from the left eye to right eye, now there is a dilatation. You can see bigger size pupil. So we have no direct light reflex and we have no indirect light reflex. So what is this? That means it is RAPD. And which eye RAPD? Right eye RAPD, because when I am showing the light in the right eye, I am not getting the direct light reflex, I am not getting indirect light reflex. Jabki left eye pe I am getting direct also or indirect also. So left eye ki optic nerve intact hai, right side ki optic nerve problem hai, which is called as the right RAPD. It is also called as Marcus Gunn pupil. Theek hai? So let us see. Option number A, is it related to Marcus Gunn pupil? Yes, it is related. Is it related to papal edema? No. Because papal edema is passive. Papal edema is passive. We do not have any active optic nerve lesion here. Now, because I am not having any optic nerve, active optic nerve lesion here, I am not going to get the abnormal pupillary reactions. Argyll Robertson pupil, no. Argyll Robertson pupil mein, you will get the bilateral irregularly constricted pupil. Here you are getting the dilatation, while in the Argyll Robertson pupil we have accommodation reflex present. So there we have accommodation reflex present. So I will have bilateral irregularly constricted pupil. And pinpoint pupil, no, because this is a dilated pupil, so it's not pinpoint pupil. So what will be the answer? Marcus Gunn pupil. Marcus Gunn pupil. Then somebody was asking me the fundus image difference between the optic neuritis and the papal edema. See, optic neuritis may you can have normal optic disc like in retrobulbar neuritis. Then I can also have the macular star formation. Macular star I will get in neuroretinitis. Normal fundus I will get in retrobulbar neuritis. And I can get the hyperemia, in which I have congestion along with the blurred margins. Along with the blurred margins also I can get. This I get in cases of the papillitis. So neuroretinitis mein I will get the macular star formation. Avinash, tumne pucha tha. Normal fundus I will get in retrobulbar neuritis. And if I am getting just redness of the optic disc along with slight blurring of the margins, then that is actually your papillitis. While a very very typical thing that you are going to get in papal edema, if it is a case of papal edema, it's a passive optic disc edema that you are getting due to the raised intracranial pressure that you are getting in the malignant hypertension. So that is typically showing me the enlargement of the blind spot. Enlargement of the blind spot I am getting. I'll get obliteration of the cup. There will be spontaneous venous pulsations. There will be blurring of the margins. And the amount of optic disc edema is 7 to 8 times of the optic neuritis. 7 to 8 times of the optic neuritis. It's very, very large. So that is your enlargement of the blind spot. And even this was a question last year, that enlargement of the blind spot is found in all except and the options were, one was your papal edema, B was open angle glaucoma, and C was your medullated optic nerve fibers was there, and number 4 was your hypoplasia of the optic disc. So here the answer was hypoplasia of the optic disc. Papal edema mein enlargement of blind spot hota hai. Medullated means myelinated optic nerve fibers. Myelination say you will have enlargement of the blind spot. Open angle glaucoma mein, because of the cave-like optic atrophy, we have an impression that is leading to the enlargement, but actually there is no enlargement, but it gives the impression. That is why open angle glaucoma is also not the answer. But certainly hypoplasia matlab small optic disc. So small optic disc mein you cannot have the enlargement of the blind spot. So that is why the answer here was the hypoplasia. Theek hai? That was your hypoplasia. Yes, you can definitely say mostly papal edema is bilateral, and yes, unilateral is optic neuritis. Can we get enlargement in optic disc drusens? Not typically, no. Because drusens are over the optic disc. Those are also autofluorescent lesions. So, the total optic disc enlargement leading to the enlargement of the blind spot, that we are not going to get there. Okay. So, this is your, this one. And then we come to the final one. So, what is the diagnosis here? I have again taken this kind of a question because you know these people are fond of asking the image based questions. So if you look at the first image, quickly hum log first options bhi dekh lete hain. We have esotropia, we have isotropia, iso iso, exo exo. Is it tropia or is it phoria? So pehle we have to see, is it a tropia or a phoria? So see, they have given you a midline there. ठीक है ना? So is it a tropia or is it a phoria? You will have to see. So if you look at this picture, this is your midline. So it is slightly towards inwards. So it is actually manifesting. ठीक है ना? So it is manifesting. So first of all, you will have to see ki is it manifesting or not. ठीक है? So when you see the first picture, it is actually the central one. So I can say that it is actually a phoria because it is latent. You cannot see the squint. So it's a phoria. Then you have to check whether it is eso or exo. So we can check the latent squint phorias by two tests. I can do the cover uncover test, or we can do the Madox rod test. ठीक है? Here they have done this cover uncover test. So the moment you cover the eye, and if this eye is having a squint, it will move. ठीक है? And I cover it, it will move. So what will happen? As you remove it, it will move in the opposite direction to take its original position. So this is called as a recovery movement. So this is called as a recovery movement, and recovery movement is always taking place in the opposite direction. So if you look here, here it is taking place in the opposite direction. So it is going outward. That means the deviation was inward. So what will be the answer? Therefore, the answer will be esophoria. It is a phoria because it is not manifesting and the recovery movement is towards outside. Therefore, the deviation in this eye is esophoria. So again, just with the help of three pictures, we can give the answer here that this is esophoria. So, yes. So, I hope all these topics are clear to you guys, and I have tried to touch all the important things here, which are important, like important with respect to the INICET, and I have also tried to show you how they can be asked in the examinations, how the systemic aspect is important, how the tests are important, and how to apply them, because there are certain things that you know. You know about salt and pepper retinitis, you know about retinitis pigmentosa, but when it actually comes in the examination, we have a doubt. You know about papilledema, you know about optic neuritis, but we have a doubt. And mostly what happens when you are confused between the two options, we'll end up marking the wrong one. That is the human tendency. So I hope you could get these topics, and you do not have now that confusion that you were having, and this will certainly help you in your examination to go at the right option. And definitely that I'll do separately, Avinash, okay? Not in this session. This is regarding the HILD session and the last minute revision for the INICET. So, I hope this session helped you, and please definitely try to, those of you who could not attend live, you can see it, you have, still have time, 2 days are there, and those of you want to see it again, as you people are saying, so I'll keep it there in the recorded sessions of the YouTube so that you can revisit it, and please not only the questions, try to revisit all the topics that I have discussed, 15 important topics along with the other ones also, because we have discussed all the four options. So we have taken more than the number of questions. So maybe every question is having four options. So 15 to 460. So I think many of the higher topics have been covered today. So try to go through them. And if you have any confusion, you can always directly message me, or you can ask the question in the comment section of this video, or any place that you want. I am there at all the social media platforms. You can ask me anywhere.
And all the very best for your upcoming exams. May you come up with the flying colors. Thank you and happy ophthalmology.